Okay, it's time to bottle the beer. It's pretty much stopped working. There's no bubbles coming up through it. It's cleared up quite a bit, so it was a week on Monday, so we got Wednesday, so got our bottles together. We clean the bottles. I'll just go through that process, and then I guess I'll just show you. I'll bottle one bottle, show the process. But you just take your sanitizing stuff that's left over. I only used half originally brewing. Take the other half, add it to like a gallon jug. This would be close to a gallon here, 4 liters. Fill it with warm water. Put the rest of that in it. Use that to you fill all the bottles half full. Swish them around, let them sit for 10 minutes, and dump them out. Clean them all, so it's about 8 liters of beer, or 2 gallons. So we got 24 bottles here, I think, or 25, something like that. That should work out. And these are, well, most of them are Corona bottles, 330 milliliters. I just figured they'd be easier to deal with. Clear bottle, you can see what you're doing easier. And I got some Red Stripe stubby bottles, because I like stubby bottles. So anyway, clean them all up, take them upstairs, and start bottling. So you clean them, then you put a little bit of white sugar in it, and it calls for that size bottle. It calls for 3/4 of a tablespoon, or teaspoon, I mean. And so you just scoop a little bit into each, and we got our funnel here, bottle caps. So we just sanitize all of that stuff, the funnel, the measure, I'll sanitize the caps just for these have been sitting around for a while. And they were 25 cents for 150 caps. Anyway, so we'll go through all that, and then we'll be back. Okay, here we
are. Alright, so we're going to bottle. Take our bottles, they're all clean. Take your funnel, add a little bit of sugar.
They say to tilt the bottle so it doesn't aerate the thing very much, but these long neck bottles are pretty easy to do that. Get up to about there or so, and then I'll cap it, and then shake up the, make sure the sugar dissolves, and then you put it in the same area that you let it brew in. It's like 68 to 75 degrees, and then just let it sit for a week or 2 weeks, I think it says. But and I'll show the capping after I'm done doing all the putting all the beer in the bottles.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So we got capped. Just report. That was almost like seeding bullets. Is it? Brewing is kind of like reloading or something. Takes a little long, too. Big Dad's antique capper.
It was a good capper. I've had for years.
It came over on the Hector. Yeah. It's kind of a feel thing. It's pushed down. There's like a rubber thing up in there that when it starts to squeeze, it's probably
Yeah, that looks good. Let's give that a couple tilts.
Tilt it over a couple times so your sugar dissolves.
Yeah.
And that'll prime your bottle and make it give you carbonation.
Nobody likes flat beers.
Yeah.
It's pretty good already.
Yeah.
And I think I got 24 bottles right on. The last one I got was kind of a little bit of sediment in, but it'll be all right.
It'll settle out.
Yeah. All right. I guess that's good enough.
Okay.